What is good, guys? We here with another Smoke on Snack Draft game. We have Tamahome vs. Seriemus this time. I know Tamahome's team is on the forums. It's a sample team. It's a Choice Scarf Lari, Z-Move Megina. I think it was Electrum Z with Ice Beam, Shift Gear, and I think Comet or Focus Blast was the last move. I don't remember 100%. Defensive Lando with Helmet and Rocks, so pretty standard. And Spikes, Specs, Ashgrim with Dark Pulse, Water Shoot, and Pump, so pretty standard as well. And the Venusaur is like Synthesis, Sludge Bomb, Earthquake, and Knockoff, so it doesn't have HP Fire, which means it cannot hit the Katana that well. That might be annoying for Tamahome in this matchup, because the Celesteel is actually a bit more speed def. It's like, I think, 128 speed def with plus speed def nature. So that means Katana is actually a threat in this game if it's Z-Move. If it's Scarf, he's gonna be fine, but if it's Z-Move, it's gonna be a huge threat. So the Pelipper could be Damp Rock or Specs, I'm not sure. I'm thinking it's probably Specs, because he only has one Swift Swim Abuser. And then either the Kelly or the Katana is probably the Scarfer. The Megina is definitely a Salt Vest. And the Pert is going to be the Rocker. And I think the Coco is going to be Specs, and one of these two is going to be Z-Move, and the other one is going to be Scarf. But yeah, I'm thinking it's like Specs with Scald, Hydro Pump, U-Turn, and Hurricane. This is just gonna be like Volt Switch, Iron Head, Ice Beam Slash, Flurkin, and what would be the force move? Because I don't think it's HP Fire. It could still be HP Fire if this is not Damp Rock, because the run only lasts for a few turns. But I think a Venus, actually, he doesn't want to lead Venusaur because he's fearing the Pelipper, never mind. I was gonna say maybe Venus is a good lead. But yeah, Seriemus is now gonna switch into his own Megina because this is Electrum Z, so he obviously doesn't want to lose his Kelly turn 1. Tamahome is probably gonna make a double that covers the opposing Megina, which is... He doesn't really have a great double because Landris cannot Oko AV Megina from full. So I guess Tamahome might double into Venusaur, Celesteela. Seriemus is definitely not gonna stay in with the Kelly here. I can tell you that much, he is not staying in with the Kelly. He's definitely going to his AV gear, which just waltz this gear. So unless Tamahome changed the team and has Volt Switch on this, he should double out into Venusaur or Celesteela. So we do see the Megina come out, and there's a double into Venusaur. So now he's either going to Earthquake or Knock Off. The reason why you would not Earthquake is if you feel like the Pelipper to come out on an Earthquake. And even if the Megina stays in, Knock Off would still get River item. Seriemus is either gonna Hard Switch or Volt Switch, so he probably went for slow Volt Switch because Megina cannot really touch Venusaur as he knocked off the Assault Vest. Now he can go into the Pelipper here. Or he could go Kartana if he knows that the Venusaur doesn't have HP Fire, but I assume he's gonna go Pelipper and threaten this out with a Hurricane. And Tamahome should now go into the Celesteela. It's but death, I already said that, so... if I'm Seriemus here, I would either Scald or Hydro Pump, or I guess U-Turn is an option as well. But yeah, Celesteela is coming out here for sure. He's not gonna stay in with Venusaur. Venusaur pretty much walls almost everything on Seriemus' team. It walls these four mons. And I guess Swampert could do a lot with Earthquake if it's more speed def, but it kind of still beats all of those mons 1-on-1. And even if the Katana is, if the Katana is not SD, it also beats the Katana 1-on-1. So he did just Scald it at 37. I think that's Specs because the Celesteela is Svedef. And so Celesteela is either gonna Leech Seed or Protect here. I would probably just go for Leech Seed if I'm Tamahome, but he does Protect, okay. So Swampert can either go for Rocks here or Fire off a Waterfall in the Rain. I assume Tamahome is just gonna go Hard Venusaur here. There's no point in going for Protect on the turn. He might go for Rocks on this turn, so there's not really a point in protecting here. He does just Hard Venusaur. Does he Waterfall or does he Rocks? I think Rocks would be a good play. He does just go for Rocks. So he can now threaten this out with a Giga Drain. Even though this doesn't have Giga Drain, I think, like I said, it's like Earthquake, Sludge Bomb, Knock Off, Synthesis. He's probably... I would probably go for Sludge Bomb here if I'm Tamahome. Because you don't want to let in the Pelipper for free. Seriemus might try to pivot from Megina. He might try to pivot into Megina here first. But he does go Hard Pelipper. And he gets poisoned. Yeah, I'm not the biggest fan of the play, but he didn't really have good switch-ins. So he probably just wanted to get this in on a Giga Drain, but Tamahome does not have Giga Drain. Maybe Seriemus doesn't know that. I'm guessing Tama Home is definitely just gonna switch out. Does he Hurricane this time? He does just Hurricane. That is a good chunk to the Lari. So I assume Tama Home is just gonna defog the rocks here and sack his Lari to the Pelipper, and the Pelipper is also gonna die, so it's gonna be a double down. I don't really see the Pelipper that's poisoned and at 7% doing much work, so there's no point in CDMA for switching. I guess he could go on a Megina and save this as fodder, but if he does that, then the Lari is still alive, so Tama Home also still has the Lari around. So I think staying in Hurricaning is a fine play, because the Lari is choice locked, so if the Lari, like, he will see what the Lari is locked into, but it makes sense for Tama Home to just go for defog, because the Pelipper will die to poison if it stays in. So it is just defog. Pelipper's gonna pick off the Lari with the Hurricane, and then it's a double down. And if I'm Tama Home here, I would either go to Lando or the Venusaur. Because, like, Venusaur, like I said, it waltz, like, kind of waltz CDMA's entirety. What would I do if I'm CDMA's here? That's a good question. I would either go to Cartana or Megina, probably. Like, I don't think Tama Home is gonna allow this Swampert in for free. Yeah, so my internet died, guys. I'm back now. Pretty much he went Lando and CDMA's went Megina. Earthquake does not kill the Megina because it's defensive Lando. So CDMA's might be willing to let his Megina get weakened in exchange for the Landris, because if he gets rid of the Landris, that would help him potentially win with SD Cartana later in the game. As I think he just went for Ice Beam, and he's gonna kill the Landris. If it's AD Megina, which probably has either max HP or 200 HP investment, is gonna be able to eat up the Earthquake, as he's probably just gonna pump here. Yep, that does a lot. That's obviously specs, as the Keldeo comes out, and the Keldeo is probably just gonna go for Secret Sword here. Pretty much, if Tama Home had a regular Venusaur set with HP Fire, I think a Venusaur would just 6-0 at this point. But CDMA still has hope. Since the Venusaur does not have a move to hit the Cartana, he can still win. So it is just pick off the Greninja. So that Keldeo Scarf, that makes me think that the Cartana is SD. And I don't know how Tama Home beats SD Cartana if it's Z move. Because, like I said, the Venusaur can't touch it. So now CDMA is just gonna sack something. And then he has to go on a Cartana afterwards, so he does sack his Megina, where I forgot that his Megina was at 9%, so that was obviously the play to make to sack. I thought it was a bit healthier, so now he's just gonna, like, he's just gonna Earthquake to kill the Megina, and now he's forced into Cartana because everything else does not beat the Venusaur. And if Tama Home changed the Venusaur to HP Fire, the game is gonna end right here, and CDMA just loses. But if it's not HP Fire, CDMA can win with the Cartana, so he's gonna SD up here with Cartana. As if Venusaur does not have HP Fire, it can only go for Earthquake. So he does not have HP Fire because he went Hard Celesteela. And I assume this is an all-out pummeling Cartana. And Celesteela can, I guess, go for Protect. If CDMA SDs again, predicting a Protect, I think the game just ends right here. But even if he doesn't, even if he just all-out pummelings on a Protect, it will still do a lot, a good chunk. And Second Shot might kill after. Did I say Second Sword? I always mix up the names. Yeah, that was the correct name. So he does pummel on the Protect. Let's see how much it does. It is 28, so I'm pretty sure that's a more speed of Sealer. Like I said, a team preview. This is a forums team. He did not change it, so this is a roll. If the Celesteela would have been Fist Death, it would have been heavily in Tama Home's favor to lift that, but he was more speed of. And now he goes Venusaur, but the way he played the Venusaur, he switched it earlier, means he does not have HP Fire. So Smart Strike is going to 2-hit KO the Venusaur, and Earthquake is only going to do like 30% or 40%. It's not going to do much, like 30, I would guess. It's 23, it did nothing. Yeah, the game's over. So he just won with Cartana. So if you, like, usually, like, if I did not know that Tama Home's Venusaur didn't have HP Fire, I would have thought that he could not win this game at all. But that was pretty much what CDMA had to hope for. And he was able to just sweep him with Cartana. Cartana's just crazy offensively. One of the reasons why I prefer Fist Death Celesteela over Spidef. But I do understand the purpose of more Spidef Celesteela. Because the Megina is not Spidef, which means he kind of needs, like, a Spidef mon to, like, check Greninja. But he also has Venusaur. But like, says the devil, the devil's also able to check Pelipper a bit better in this match. But thank you guys for watching, and peace out.